Happy Sabbath, everyone. It's good to be in the house of the Lord this morning, amen? Yes, God has seen us safely through another week, and so it's only fitting that we give him praise this morning. From within, we want to begin with a word of prayer. We're kindly asking you to stand as we invite God's presence in our midst. Heavenly Father, we thank you for bringing us all here today, Lord. We thank you for seeing another beautiful Sabbath day. And we ask that you continue to bless us as we sing praises unto your name, Lord. In your name I pray, amen. Amen, amen. Come, Christians, join to sing. Hallelujah, amen. Hymn number 10 in our SDA hymnal. Come, Christians, join to sing. Let's sing.
Come, Christians, join to sing.
Shots are on me by this we do now. praise the Lord. We want to turn to
hymn number 212. There's almost time for the Lord to come.
Tell me the story of Jesus, write on my heart every word. Tell me the story most precious, sweetest that ever was heard. Let's go, tell me
the story of Jesus, write on my heart every word. greatest that ever was heard.
Fasting alone.
Fasting alone in the desert. Tell of the days that he passed.
For our sins.
He was tempted, yet was triumphant at last.
And for our last hymn, we will turn to hymn 308, I will be their Savior, holy thine, teach me how.
Holy,
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Happy Sabbath, everyone. Happy Sabbath, everyone, and all those who are viewing online, happy Sabbath to you. This morning, the privilege is mine to welcome you to the house of the Lord. You see, Psalm 122 verse 1 says, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord to worship. And we are here to worship this morning. Amen. Anybody come to worship this morning? If you come to worship, say amen. 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 For we have life and we have it more abundantly. Let everything that has breath praise the Lord. This morning I'm just here to welcome you to our communion, welcome you to church this morning as we stand at this moment and sing our opening song, hymn number 15.
Happy Sabbath, everyone. At this point in time, we'll take our Bibles or turn to the screen and we'll read our scripture reading today, which is taken from Isaiah 53, verses 3 to 5. When it is found, please say amen. All right. Let's go. So it says, in fact, let's read together after 4. He is despised and rejected of men, a man of sorrows and acquainted with grief, and we hid as it were our faces from him. He was despised and we esteemed him not. Surely he hath borne our griefs and carried our sorrows. Yet we did esteem him stricken, smitten of God, and afflicted. But he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him, and with his stripes we are healed. So it's time for the morning prayer. So, if anyone feels the need to come to the altar, because there's always blessings at the altar. Feel free to come, even as we sing, I need thee every hour. As far as possible, if you can. But let's pray. Heavenly Father, we your children do come into your presence on this Sabbath day. Lord, it's communion time. And Father, firstly, we'd like to give you thanks for the sacrifice that you've made for us on Calvary many years ago. Father, we ask that even before we partake in the service, that you would search us, you would wash us, cleanse us of all sin, of all self, and all unrighteousness. Father, you know our needs. You know us through and through. So, Father, whatever is heavy on our hearts, we ask that you would take that burden away from us. Lord, cover us, keep us, cleanse us, dear Father. May we, who come seeking a blessing today, not be disappointed. Whatever we come seeking for, Father, if it's healing, may we find it in you. If it's restoration, may we find it in you, dear Father. Even as Pastor breaks the word, we ask that you would cover him, dear Father. We know that the devil is busy, but Father, we know you don't sleep, and we know that you are always on duty 24/7, dear Father. So cover him, cover his family, cover this church, cover every member here, dear Lord. And may we all be blessed and leave here rejoicing, knowing that you are God, you are good. We have come to you in seeking a blessing, and we have not been disappointed. So, Father, thank you for hearing our prayer. Even for those, dear Father, who would be making that decision today for baptism, may your Holy Spirit be with them, keep them, cover them. Father, cold feet, that do exist with you. So, Father, give them the strength, give them the courage, continue to encourage them, and may we as a church encourage them to continue to hold on to you while keeping our hands in the hand of the man that stilled the waters, is our prayer. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
All right, morning church, we have come to worship, and offering and tithes is part of our worship experience. At this time, I want to ask the deacons and deaconesses to take their places. I want to share with you a passage of scripture where God expects us to give, and we expect to receive a blessing from him. So I want to share with you from Malachi chapter 3, verses 8 unto 11. Malachi 3, verse 11, I'd read in your hearing. And I will ask God's blessing on the offering after. It says here, will a man rob God? Yet he have robbed me. But he say, wherein have we robbed thee? In tithes and offering. Ye are cursed with a curse, for ye have robbed me, even this whole nation. Bring ye all the tithes into the storehouse, that there may be meat in my house. And prove me now wherewith, saith the Lord of hosts, if I will not open to you the windows of heaven and pour you out a blessing, that there will not be room enough to receive it. And verse 11 tells us, special blessing, and I will rebuke the devourer for your sake, and he shall not destroy the fruits of your ground, neither shall your vine cast her fruits. Neither shall your vine cast her fruit before the time in the field, saith the Lord of hosts. So God has promised us blessings when we return to him his tithes and offering. Let's bow our heads as we give praise and thanks this morning that we can return our tithes and offering to him. Father, this morning we thank you for the gift that you have given us, the gift of life and the opportunity to work. This morning we have brought our tithes, we have brought our offering, we have brought our gifts before you. We pray now, God, you are accepted at our hands. And we pray that your blessings would be on it for the purpose for which it is given, that it would be used. We would be blessed and lifted and drawn closer to you. This is my prayer with thanksgiving in Jesus' blessed name. Amen and amen. The deacons will now wait on us for gift, tithes, and offering.
Good morning, happy Sabbath to all. These are announcements for March 23rd, 2024. Have you filled out your Google form so your church family can celebrate with you? Thank you to those who have already done so, and we encourage each one of you to fill out the form. The form has been pinned at the top of the church WhatsApp chat. The funeral service of Brother Peter Ogis will be held on Monday, March 25th, 2024 at the Arima SDA Church, Degan Street, Arima, at 10 a.m. We will be having service at the Ogis residence, Mantis Lane, La Horquetta, tomorrow evening, March 24th at 6:30 p.m. Please come and support the family at this time of bereavement. Mid-year Camp Balantra 2024 is on. See the flyer on the church WhatsApp chat for more details. Family Life Ministries will be hosting their prayer and fast program on Sabbath, April 6th, 2024 at 9 a.m. Not 9:30, but 9 a.m. Theme, Building Healthy Families. We look forward to your attendance. Children's Ministry would like to announce our creation outing, Picnic in the Savannah. This is on Wednesday, April 3rd, 2024. There will be kite flying, collage making, and much more. All interested persons, please contact any member of the Children's Ministry team. Our grand homecoming day is Sabbath, April 13th, 2024. Let's begin inviting our members to come back home. La Horquetta Adventist Society is reminding you to start prepping for our Keep Fit Treasure Hunt on Sunday, March 31st, 2024. Venue, Church Car Park, time 7 a.m. Come out in your numbers. Sabbath School is reminding us to pay attention to the signs on the walls, so you will see signs on both sides. The new classes will be based on the area that you live. So on the sign that you will see if it's phases 1, 2, 3, etc. on the outskirts, that will be your new Sabbath class. The Lindsay family would like to extend a heartwarming thank you to all the members for their prayers, support, and love. May God continue to bless you. Join us in our weekly prayer services, which are Sunday mornings, 6:30 a.m., Wednesday mornings, 5 a.m., and Wednesday nights, 7 p.m. For these and other announcements, as well as additional information, please see the notice board and our La Horquetta Church WhatsApp chat. Sunset times for next Sabbath, Friday 29th March, 6:15 p.m., and Sabbath 30th of March, 6:15 p.m. Thought for the week. Obedience is faith's response to what God has already done. Have a blessed Sabbath.
Amen. I want to thank Sister Abigail for the announcements this morning. At this point in time, does anyone love good gospel music? If you do, say amen. Amen. We have a special person this morning coming to sing to us this morning. It's not me. All right, if it was me, I would have done sing already. But I'm not singing this morning. So we want to welcome and put our hands. Well, let's welcome our sister, Denisha Dempster, as she blesses our hearts this morning in special music. And then followed by our pastor, Pastor Leslie Moses. Let's make welcome for Sister Denisha Dempster.
Good morning, everyone. The cross.
standing near your mother. They were so close, they could hear you sighing all around them. Angry voices, it's the darkness, and you were dying.
So you sound so not into it. I mean, I heard the Nisha sing, and that was such a lovely rendition, wasn't it? Yes. So let's say a louder amen for Denisha. Amen. Thank you, Denisha. Lovely. And I have to tell you, right, these are our children. I'm proud of our children, the children of the La Horquetta Seventh-day Adventist Church. Why are you not saying amen? Amen, it's communion. I hope by the time I'm ended, you would resoundingly say amen. Sister Alert, amen. Amen. This is a very special morning because it's a very special communion service. Today we have members of our church taking communion for the very first time. Amen. I mean, we don't make a big thing out of First Communion as some other people do, but for these individuals who are taking communion for the first time as a baptized member of the Seventh-day Adventist Church, it is a big thing. It is. And to make today, of course, today is communion, and that's the main focus, but to make today extra special, we're having a baptism. in the church. Amen. Amen. Brother Waldron, is this our first baptism in the church? First baptism in the church. Of course, we don't have a font, a built-in font, that is, but we do have a font this morning. Amen. So I've been very excited all week. And of course, the idea to do the baptism in church this morning, people don't like it when I tell the truth. But I like to tell the truth. Amen. So the idea wasn't mine. Even though I'm the leader of the congregation, the idea was, I don't remember who, one of the board members. Was it Brother Pear? Who? Joel Kerr. Okay. It was Brother Joel Kerr, and of course Brother Pear said, let's do it in the church. I remember that one. Because we could have done it outside, we could have done it in the car park. So it's going to be a part of communion today. So communion is going to be a little different. I'm going to preach, give Anna her vows, baptize her one time after the sermon or sermonette, and then we separate for foot washing. Is that all right? So baptisms are normally done at the end of the service. But we today, because it's communion, we're doing it as part of the service. Amen? So I invite us to stand. This is a special day for me. I'm very excited, as I told you, about it. And I want you to take your Bibles. And we go back to our scripture reading for today. But today, for the purpose of our message, and because of the need to manage our time, we would read verse 5, and I want us to read verse 5 together. Verse 5 is the key verse. Yeah, hold on. We have members coming in. We want them to come in. Amen. Verse 5, Isaiah 53. Mr. McWilliams, you could sit up front here. Yes. All right. All right. Isaiah 53 and verse 5. We have it. And if you don't, it's on the screen. It says, read with me. And I don't want you to read it as you said amen. I'm telling you from now, right? Verse 5 says, but he was wounded for transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace were upon him, and with his stripes we are healed. Amen. Bless you with our hearts today, Lord, we pray. In Jesus' name, amen. Have your seats, please, in the presence of the Lord. Communion reminds us and tells us, it informs us of the fact that Jesus died. By the way, if you are visiting church today, welcome. Special welcome. I see Brother Agard's family members are here. Thank you for coming back. Brother Agard, God bless you. Sister Agard, you too. Amen. And to all the other visitors, we have quite a few visitors. Welcome to church today. Communion reminds us that Jesus died. That is what it is about. And the reason we we do communion is to help us, number one, is to help us humble ourselves as Jesus did. He was God, but he subjected himself to be a servant, a slave. So he is our servant leader. So that whatever he says, we will do. Whatever he beckons us to, or wherever he beckons us to, we will go. Because we follow him. Amen? It was Jesus who died. But the Apostle Paul, in the book of Corinthians, tells us that baptism is the way we commemorate the death. Well, one of the ways, I should say, we commemorate the death, burial, and resurrection of Jesus. Amen. And so having a baptism on communion Sabbath is a perfect illustration of what happened with Jesus. Amen. So Jesus died. He suffered. He bled. And he died. In Mark chapter 15, verse 15, the Bible says, and so Pilate, willing to contend the people, released Barabbas unto them and delivered Jesus when he had scourged him. And in the original language, scourge means to flog. When he had flogged him, he delivered him to be crucified. One day, a little orphan girl, about 5 years old, she was told by the nurse, "You have a visitor." The nurse pre-warned her and prepared her for the visitor. The nurse said, "The lady who is coming to see you is severely crippled. Her back and her hands were withered. Her whole body was scarred with deep wounds that made her look like something out of a horror movie. Her hair was blotched and didn't grow in many places. And her lips were all gone. And she could hardly breathe." Now the nurse said to the girl, the 5-year-old girl, "No matter what you think about her, remember, she's your mother." When the mother entered the room where the 5-year-old was, the girl said, "No, no, no. I don't want to see you anymore." She was scared and petrified because of the sight of seeing that crooked, mangled woman. And then the woman, her mother said, "Before you chase me out, hear my story. And if it is you don't ever want to see me again, I will be okay with that. But hear my story." The mother said, "When you were just a baby, I was doing laundry outside. And when I looked, I saw our house on fire. I dropped everything. And because I didn't know where you were, I went from room to room until I found you. By the time I found you, I got a blanket, I got a towel, and I wrapped you in it. I wrapped you totally and thoroughly. And then I had to make my way out. In escaping the raging fires, I got burnt all over my body. But that was not my concern. My concern was that I saved you. Because we had nowhere to live, and because I was so sick, I couldn't keep you. So I had to give you up to the state to raise you. But I'm better now. I have my own home now, and I came to get you back. If you don't want me, I'm okay. But I just want you to know that I endured all of that because I loved you. Sad, but true. What Jesus endured on the cross was exactly and much, much more in intensity than what that dear woman endured for her daughter. And if you were to ask Jesus, why did you go to the cross? Why did you endure the flogging? And by the way, in those days, flogging is not like what you get when you're home. You know, as a child, as children, we get a little flogging every now and then. A little beating with a leather whip, a leather belt rather. Or in my days, children, it used to be a guava whip or tamarin whip. Any of the older ones remember the tamarin whip and the guava whip? Sister Duncan, you had any of those at home? I don't think so. It was nothing like that. In the days of scourging, in the days of flogging, in the times of Jesus, the instrument used for flogging, brothers and sisters, were leather straps. Five of them, and on each strap there was either steel or bone, so that when the strap hit you and they pulled it, flesh came out. That is what Jesus endured along the way. Of course, worse than the flogging was the torture he experienced while on the cross, there suspended between heaven and hell for you and for me. And one would ask, why would he do it? He did it because he loves us, or because he loved us. And you know, I say from time to time, right? I say from time to time, if I was Jesus, and if I was on the cross, and they were mocking me, and they were persecuting me, and they were torturing me, and then I would hear, if you are really the Son of God, save yourself and save us. I would look to heaven and say, Lord, just give me 1 minute with them, please. Just 1 minute. I will come off that cross. I would put on my clothes and I would show all them people who were beating me and mocking me and humiliating me, I would show all of them who was the boss. But can I tell us today, brothers and sisters, Jesus did not come to be the boss. Jesus came to be the servant leader, to show us how to treat people when we are treated badly by them. He came to show us how to react and how to respond when things don't go our way. Of course, Jesus knew what he was getting into when he came to earth, and he understood full well that part of the plan, part of the deal, was to die. And I'm happy the prophet Isaiah, considered to be the fifth gospel. You know, you have Matthew, Mark, Luke, John. Well, most scholars add another gospel, Isaiah. Because you see, Isaiah speaks about Jesus more than any of the Old Testament books and prophets and writings. Isaiah tells us and gives us very significant and intimate details about Jesus. You heard some of it in our scripture reading. But for the sake of time, Isaiah said, he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him, and with his stripes we are healed. I thank God today for the healing that comes through the blood of Jesus. I thank God today that because of those stripes that he received, because of the scourging, because of the flogging, because of that, today, as a church, taking communion, some of you, for the first time, you take it with the understanding that because of his stripes, you are healed, because of his flogging, you are healed. He took it for you and for your healing. Our shackles became his shame. Our torment became his torture. Our grief, he grieved with. Our cross of shame and sorrow was his cross of sacrifice. And that's why the songwriter could have written, I was guilty with nothing to say, and they were coming to take me away. When a voice from heaven was heard that said, let him go and take me instead. And then the refrain, I should have been crucified. I should have suffered and died. I should have hung on the cross in disgrace. But Jesus, God's Son, he took my place. Can I declare to you today, brothers and sisters, can I declare to you today that he was wounded for your transgressions? He was bruised for your iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him, and with his stripes we are healed. I'm glad that Jesus took my place so that I can get healing. And there's a big debate. You know, people are wondering, is this real healing? And I'm going to close with this. Is this real healing? Physical healing? Is this symbolic healing? Is it spiritual healing? And if I had the time, I would tell you that Jesus, when he began to heal the people, the Bible says in the book of Matthew chapter 8, that his healing of the people, his physical healing of the people, was to fulfill this prophecy. Amen. But can I also tell you today, brothers and sisters, that not only was there and is there physical healing because of the stripes that Jesus endured for us, but there is also spiritual healing. Somebody say amen. Peter, in 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 24 says, "Who his own self bore our sins in his own body on the tree, that we, being dead to sins, should live unto righteousness, by whose stripes ye are healed." In other words, the good news is that this healing that the stripes of Jesus affords is not just physical healing, but it is spiritual healing in Jesus' name. Somebody say amen. And in spite of what people say, what Jesus did on Calvary is full, it's free, it's complete, and it is total. Amen. Amen. So let me just say this. And I'm saying this for one person in the congregation, and she knows who she is. One person. Sometimes we are sick and we read the Bible and we wonder, is the Bible true and accurate and authentic? Because I'm sick. And with his stripes, I'm supposed to be healed, but I'm not. And we wonder, well, Jesus teaches that the healing is physical. Amen. And don't say to yourself, I have to go to some evangelical church, you know, some faith healer to get healing. You don't. Because I've seen Brother McWilliams over and over again, where we have prayed for people and they got healing. Amen. But I've also seen that we have prayed for people over and over and they did not. So it's really up to God, not the preacher, not the pastor. It's up to God. If it was up to the preacher or to the pastor, then everybody in this congregation would be healed in Jesus' name. Amen. And all the people in the hospital would be healed in Jesus' name. Amen. It's really up to God. He determines. And so the physical healing is important. But can I declare to us today, brothers and sisters, that for me, the spiritual healing is more important? Amen. The spiritual healing is more important because guess what? Jesus raised Lazarus from the dead. But what happened to him a few years later? He died again. So there is a temporary healing if you are healed now. What is important is not so much whether you healed now or not. What is important is that the ultimate healing that comes at the resurrection, when this mortal will put on immortality, when this corruptible will put on incorruption, and we are raised in the presence of God to live forevermore. That, I declare to you, is the healing that I want. Amen. Yes, I want to live. I have a little grandbaby. I want to see him grow up and drive me around town. But if God says no, then I'm good with that. Because what I really want is the healing that is permanent. Amen. That's called spiritual healing. And today, as I wrap it up, as a people, as a church, the thing we pray for is always for the will of God to be fulfilled in our lives. If God says yes, yes is yes. Thank you, Jesus. If God says no, no is no. Thank you, Jesus, nonetheless. And sometimes, you know, as a people, we can't take no, right? We like to hear yes. And many of us like to be yes people. You know, we feel we are more appreciated and, you know, we are more revered, we are more cherished when we could say yes for everything. I wish I could say yes for everything, everything that's good. But sometimes we say no. And sometimes Jesus says no. So, a voice was heard on the radio. Turn south. First voice. Second voice said, no, you turn north. First voice repeated, I said, turn south. This is a Navy ship. First voice said, I said, no, you turn north. Second voice says, this is the naval ship, Washington, battleship. First voice says, this is the lighthouse, turn north. As big as we are, as much as we think we know, sometimes when God says no, no is better than yes. Father, help us. Help us today. As a church, as a people, to discern your voice, to hear you speaking to us, and to follow. We know, Lord, that while on this side, we may not have all that we need. Things may not be as good as we want it. We may have bigger dreams and better dreams, as far as we are concerned, than what you have planned. But help us, Lord, to know your voice and to follow. I pray you would bless us today as we do communion. I pray, Lord, that you would touch hearts and lives. That as we have communion today, Lord, we would indeed surrender our all to Jesus, because he surrendered his all for us. Bless us now as we go into our baptism. And then as we go into the next baptism, the foot washing ceremony. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. So we have one candidate for baptism. And I'm going to invite her to come forward now. Of course, her mother is here. Amen. All right. So Katie Caton. That's what I was trying to get. That has a nice ring to it. Amen. God bless you, my sister. We are happy to have you in church today. Of course, when we had our baptism the other day, Anna Caton came forward for baptism. Amen. Her name was already voted by the board. She took the vows and you voted. But there needed to be a delay. And I thank God that the delay was not forever. Amen. And so on the board, when we discussed it last Sunday, we decided, why not baptize her before communion so she could have her first communion as a baptized member? And that's why the baptism is now. This is a special thing. Amen. And so I'm just going to give her the alternative vows, and then we'll just take the vote. A second vote to reaffirm. Do you accept Jesus, Anna, as your personal Savior and Lord? And do you desire to live your life in a saving relationship with Him? Yes. Respond.
Yes.
Amen. Do you accept the teachings of the Bible as expressed in the statement of fundamental beliefs of the Seventh-day Adventist Church? And do you pledge by God's grace to live your life in harmony with these teachings? These are the things we taught you upstairs, and the vows we give you the last time.
I do.
Do you desire to be baptized as a public expression of your belief in Jesus Christ and to be accepted into the fellowship of the Seventh-day Adventist Church and to support the church in its mission as a faithful steward by your personal influence, tithes, and offerings, and a life of service?
I do.
Amen. Very good. And you know, I just need to say this. I'm going to ask the head deacon and the head deaconess to come forward now. So let's take the vote and then I will say what I was going to say. Is there a motion that we baptize Anna Caton this morning in the church? Turn around, Anna. Turn around. Is there a motion? Is there a second to that motion? All in favor, please show by waving your hand. Amen. Everybody. Opposed by the same sign, it is carried. So you could give up the mic now, Anna. I visited somebody this week. I wouldn't call his name. I told him I wouldn't call his name, but I thought I would share this. And this brother said to me, Pastor, I believe in tithes and offerings. Amen. He said to me, Pastor, I know if we don't return tithes and offerings, there would be no work, there would be no money to pay you. Now, all the money don't come to me. If it did, then I would be a rich man, because you have so many people in this church. But it goes to pay all the pastors. Whether he has one church or three churches, it goes to help with education. It goes to help with evangelism, crusades, and buying books like The Great Controversy and so on. So he said, Pastor, I know it is important, but I don't believe in 10%. He said, and it made sense to me. I have to think about this thing some more. Brother Pear, he said to me, if Jesus said that you don't have to sleep with a man or woman to commit adultery, just think it. In other words, Jesus raised the bar, Brother First Elder. And if it was 10% in the Old Testament, and Jesus came, Sister Alert, and raised the bar, then it should be 20%. Or 30%. I mean, the thing blew my mind, Sister Treasurer. So I'm still musing on it. But to me, it makes good sense. And I just want to encourage our members, Anna, you are getting baptized today. Please be faithful to God. I want to encourage all our church members, whether you're a pensioner or you are a full-time employee somewhere, if you are faithful to God, God will be faithful to you. And he will bless you. Somebody say amen. 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 So we're going to sing one song. I hope the choristers know it. Take me to the water to be baptized. I want to get all the elders, whether you're sitting in the congregation, Brother Johnson Lee from where you are, and Brother Daryl Lee from where you are, Brother Coffee Lee from where you are, and I want you all to come up front. This is a special occasion, and we want to make this real special. Brother Head Deacon, where are you? All right, come on. Where's the Head Deaconess? Sister Pear, where is Sister Pear? All right, so the song we are singing is Take Me to the Water to be Baptized. Anna, come this way, please. Bible says, as many as believe in him, to them gave he power to become the sons and daughters of God. My dear sister Anna Curtin, because of the profession of your faith in the Lord Jesus Christ, and because you have decided to follow him all the way, we now baptize you on this holy Sabbath communion day in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Let the whole church say amen.
What can make me whole again?
Nothing.
Nothing but the blood of Jesus. Oh, precious is the flow that makes me white as snow. No other found I know. Nothing but the blood of Jesus.
Sorry. So we've had our first baptism in church. Amen. Do you agree that we should get one of these fonts for the church? Amen. Amen. The board discussed it. Brother Elder, you heard what the member said. Sister Treasurer, she stepped outside. Brother Personal Ministries Leader, you heard what the member said. We will get one by God's grace. And all of our baptism will either be here or in the park or the side, so that we don't have to be running up to Arima anymore. Unless we have 100 to baptize on a Sabbath. Amen. The Seventh-day Adventist Church believes in what we call open communion. What that simply means is that if you are a visitor to the church, but you understand what Jesus did for you on Calvary, and you're willing to forgive, you're willing to have him forgive you of your sins, and you're willing to walk, you know, as much as you know, according to his will, then you're invited to participate in the communion service. You may not be baptized. You may be a returning member, because there are several of those in church today. And you just want to say, Lord, I give my life to you. I give my life to you, then you are free to participate. The women will follow the women, and they go to the children's division in the back. The men go upstairs. All are welcomed, because this is the house of God. God bless you. All right, yes, okay.
Amen. Were you blessed this morning? Amen, indeed, we were blessed. I want to send my heartfelt congratulations to our candidate, Annalisa Keaton, on her decision in following Jesus this morning. At this moment, we will stand and sing our hymn of separation, hymn number 109, Marvelous Grace. And on the third verse, the men will be separate to go upstairs and wash their feet. So hymn number 109, Marvelous Grace.
Thank you.
take our seats. Good morning, church. We will just continue to our singing by singing number 608, Faith is the Victory.
Comes along the hills of light, ye Christian soldiers rise, and press the battles in the night, shall fill the glowing skies. against the foes and bears below. Let all our strength be heard. It is a victory we know that overcomes the world. Faith is a victory. Faith is a victory. Oh, glorious victory that overcomes the world. On every hand a foe we find, drawn up in dread array. Let tents of ease be left behind, and onward to the fray. Salvation's helmet on each head, with roots all guilt apart. The youth shall tremble, needs a tread, and echo with a shout. Faith is a victory. Faith is a victory, oh glorious victory that overcomes the world. To him that overcomes the foe, what raiment shall be given? Before the angels he shall know his name confessed in hell. Then onward from the hills of light, our hearts with love of him, will vanish all the hosts of night, in Jesus' conquering name. Faith is a victory, faith is a victory, oh glorious victory that overcomes the world.
We will now sing number 183, I Will Sing of Jesus' Love. Please join with us as we sing. Please don't feel free to clap your hands and sing lustily with us.
I will sing of Jesus' love, sing of him who first loved me for he left. The depths of love divine, little heaven can never know how to sin. As dark as mine can be made as white as snow. I will sing of Jesus' love, endless praise. Nothing good for him I've done.
How could he
such love be so? Lord, I owe my heart is won. Help me now my love to show. I will sing of Jesus' love. Endless praise my heart shall. That I might live, I will sing his love to me.
anyone have a selection that they would like us to sing? We'll now sing number 33, Sing a New Song to the Lord.
A new song to the Lord, He to whom wonders we love. Rejoice in His triumph and tell of His fall. Oh, sing a new song to the Lord. Now to the end of the earth. Salvation is shown, and still He remembers His mercy and truth, unchanging in love to His own. Sing a new song and rejoice, publish His praises abroad. Let voices in chorus with trumpet and horn resound for the joy of the Lord. Join with the hills and the seas, thunders of praise to prolong. In judgment and justice He comes to the earth. Oh, sing a new song to the
You will now sing number 474, Take the Name of Jesus with You.
Take the name of Jesus with you, child of sorrow and of woe. It will joy and comfort give you, take it then where you go. Precious name, oh how sweet, hope of joys and joy of heaven. Precious name, and joy of heaven. Take the name of Jesus ever as a shield from every snare. If temptations round you gather, read that holy name in prayer. Precious name, oh how sweet, oh power and joy of heaven. Precious name, oh how sweet, hope of earth and joy of heaven.
At the name of Jesus falling, falling prostrate at His feet. King of kings in heaven,
journey is complete.
Jesus' name, oh, have seat. Hope of earth and joy of heaven.
Thank you for joining with us, Auntie.
Testing. Less than one. Testing. Testing. Testing.
Testing. Thank you. fasting.
To continue our singing while the guys are still upstairs. We want to still enjoy some praise and worship, and in order to do so, we all have to take part. So I know we would like to socialize, and we have seen folks that we haven't seen for some time, but let's use this time and sing together. And we don't have any instruments, but we have our hands. Amen. We have our hands, so we can clap and make a joyful noise unto the Lord. And can it be hymn 198, and can it be that I should gain an interest in the Savior's blood? Died he for me, who caused his pain for me,
who him to death pursued, and can it be?
And can it be that I should gain an interest in the Savior's blood?
Died
he for me who caused his pain, for me who him to death pursued.
Amazing
love, how can it be that thou,
my God,
should die for me? Amazing love, how can it be that thou, my God, should die for me?
He left his father's throne.
He left his father's throne above.
So free,
so free, so infinite
his emptied
himself of all but love. And bled for Adam's helpless.
Tis
mercy all immense and free. Though, my God, it found of me. Amazing love, how can it be that oh my God should die for me?
Long
my imprisoned spirit lay,
fast bound
in sin and nature's
thine eyes diffused
a quickening ray. I woke a dungeon flame with
my
love.
My chains fell off,
my heart was free. I rose and followed thee. Amazing love, how can it be that oh my God should die for me?
Last verse, the congregation, you have it. No.
No condemnation.
Join you,
oh, I approach the eternal
throne.
I claim the crown through Christ my own. Amazing love, how can it be that all my God should die for me?
Pick up the pace a little bit. All right, we're gonna sing Watch Ye Saints with Eyelids Waking. Hymn 598. All right, let's go.
Watch Ye Saints with Eyelids Waking. Lord, the path of hell not shake.
Story.
Yeah.
Trust and obey. Hymn number 590. Thank you.
All right, let's go. When we walk away in the light of His word, what a glory He sheds on our ways. While we do His good will, He abides.
still, and with all who will trust and obey, trust and obey, for there's no other way to be happy in Jesus but to trust and obey.
Not a shadow can rise,
not a shadow can rise,
not a
cloud. Not a doubt nor a fear, not a sigh nor a tear
can abide
while we trust and obey.
Trust and obey.
For there's no other way
to be happy
in Jesus but to trust and obey.
Not a burden we bear.
Not a burden we bear.
Not a sorrow we share.
Not a sorrow we share.
But a toil.
But a toil he that richly repays. Not a grief nor a loss. Not a frown nor a cross. But it's blessed. And obey, trust and obey, for there's no other way to be happy in Jesus but to trust and obey.
But we never
can prove the delights of his love.
Then
in fellowship sweet,
we will sit at his feet.
We will sit at his feet. Or we walk by his side in the way.
What he says,
we will do. Where he says, we will go. Never fear, only trust and obey. Eternal reign, infinite days. never part again. No, never part again. What? Never part again. No, never part again. And soon we shall with Jesus reign. And never, never part again.
Everlasting.
There everlasting springs abide. And never withering flows. And but a little space divides this heavenly land from us.
We are traveling
through Emmanuel's ground. We soon shall hear the trumpet sound, and soon we shall with Jesus reign. And never, never part again.
What?
Never part again. No, never part again. What? Never part again. No, never part again. And soon we shall with Jesus reign. And never, never part again.
Could we but stand?
Could we but stand where Moses stood? Not all this was pretend good ever charm us more. We are traveling through Emmanuel's realm. We soon shall hear the trumpet sound, and soon we shall with Jesus reign. I never, never part again. What? Never part again. No, never part again. What? Never part again. No, never part again. And soon we shall with Jesus reign. And never, never part again.
Straight to him 163. Alas, indeed, my Savior bleed. 163.
Blessed Lord, to thy precious bleeding son. Oh, the pure delight of a sing-along that before thy throne I stand.
When I kneel in prayer,
when I kneel in prayer, and with thee, my God, I commune as friend with friend. Draw me nearer, nearer, blessed Lord, to the cross where thou hast died. Draw me
pleasant good morning and happy Sabbath to all. And the honor and pleasure of is mine to welcome you to the second part of this morning's service, the Lord's Table, as we partake of the emblems of God's broken body and his spilt blood. And as I reflected on the communion service this week and in preparing and planning for it, the thought of the story of the prodigal son came to mind. And I re-imaged the idea of the father. The Bible says that when the son, the prodigal son, was yet afar off, that his father saw him and ran to him and held him close. And I wondered, how could the father run to the son when he was afar off? It was impressed upon me that the father must have been waiting and watching and looking out for him, expecting his return. And so I pictured us at this communion service this morning, and our father waiting and expecting and wishing that we would come. And he's there with open arms awaiting our arrival. And so this morning as we come, God is waiting with open arms. He's waiting with a loving heart. He's awaiting our presence, for he's awaiting us to come to him as he is full of grace, full of mercy. And so as the father threw his arms around the son, anything that the son had done before at that time, it just didn't matter. In spite of how dirty and messed up, the story says that the son was eaten in pig style, so he must have been dirty and messed up. And yet the father embraced him. And so as I reflect maybe upon my own life, and some of us may have such an experience, we may think to ourselves, we are dirty, we are messed up, we have done all possible wrong things. Yet here is God this morning, waiting with open arms to receive us, with arms of love, grace, and mercy. And so as we partake of the emblems this morning, as we are here, let us forget what we have done. Let us put it aside, because God has already cast our sins into the depths of the sea, and forgiveness is a reality for us all. And so I'm so happy this morning that I can be redeemed by the blood of the Lamb, in spite of what has happened, in spite of what I have done, in spite of where I have been. I can sing the song that I'm redeemed, and so I can proclaim it. I'm redeemed by the blood of the Lamb. I am redeemed through his infinite mercy, his child, and forever I am. As we sing these songs, may we sing it with conviction, knowing that God has redeemed us. And so to all our visiting friends, all our regular members, all our online viewers, we are saddened that you can't be physically here, but may we receive God's blessings this morning as we receive his grace, his love, and his mercy.
We want to stand as we sing this hymn, hymn 338, Redeem How I Love to Proclaim It. Let's sing.
Redeem how I love to proclaim it, redeem by the blood of the Lamb, redeem through his
infinite mercy, His child and forever I am. Redeemed, redeemed, redeemed by the blood of the Lamb. Redeemed, redeemed, His child and forever I am. I think of my blessed Redeemer. I think of Him all the day long. I sing, for I cannot be silent. His love is the team of my soul. I am redeemed, redeemed, redeemed by the blood of the Lamb. Redeemed, redeemed, His child and forever I am. I know I shall see Him in beauty, the King in whose law I who lovingly guarded my footsteps. I give and be son in the night. I am redeemed, redeemed, redeemed by the blood of the Lamb. Redeemed, redeemed, His child and forever I am.
Our scripture reading. Our reading scripture on the bread comes from 1 Corinthians chapter 11. 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verses 23 and 24. I'm reading as you follow. For I have received of the Lord that which also I delivered unto you, that the Lord Jesus, the same night in which He was betrayed, took bread. And when He had given thanks, He broke it and said, take, eat. This is my body, which is broken for you. This do in remembrance of me.
At this time we would bow our heads, and we here at the rostrum will kneel as we pray on the bread. Our great and eternal Father who art in heaven, we are grateful this morning for this blessed privilege that only you had afforded us to come here today in celebration of what you have done for us. We are so thankful and we are so glad that you have shared your body, as it were, to save us from sin. When we look back and as we read and as we remember what you have done, we pray, dear Father, that we will totally surrender our lives to you. Many of us have come this morning with so many ailments and not feeling well. But we are thankful this morning that your word reminds us, with every stripe that you were beaten with, we can be healed. Heal us today, dear Father, physically and also spiritually. And as we reflect on what you have done, may it bring to our minds what an awesome God we serve. We pray, Lord, that the bread, as we partake of it this morning, that it will remind us how you have allowed your body to be bruised and battered and eventually be crucified so that we can live and have eternal life. So bless us as we celebrate and as we partake of it. May it do our bodies well, we pray, not only physically, but also spiritually, is our prayer in Jesus' name.
Sabbath, everyone.
His heart was broken, mine was mended. He became sin, now I am free. The cross he carried, my burden. The nails that held him set me free. His life for mine, his life for mine. How could it ever be that he would die? God's son would die to save a wretch like of suffering, they brought me healing. He shed his blood to fill my soul. His crown of thorns made me royalty. His sorrow gave me joy.
To join together as we sing song number 159, 159. On a hill far away stood an old rugged cross, the emblem of what? But I love that old cross because the dear is not blessed to a world that was lost to sin. So let's join together as we sing this song.
On a hill far away.
On a hill far away.
Stood that old rugged cross.
Stood that old rugged cross. The emblem of suffering and shame.
And I love that old cross.
And I love.
Cross.
To that old rugged
I will ever
cross,
be true.
Oh, I will ever be true.
It shames and reproach gladly.
It shame and reproach gladly bear.
Till he calls me someday to my home far away.
Till he calls me someday to my home
far away.
Far away.
Amen and amen. I told you this was a very special communion service, right? Because we have quite a few persons who are having communion as a baptized member for the very first time. And if you're one of those, I just want you, wherever you are, those who got baptized recently, those who got baptized some time ago, it's your first communion as a baptized member. Just wave your hand wherever you are. Let me see you. Yes. Look at them.
all over the congregation. Welcome to your first communion. Amen. Do we all have bread? If you didn't get, just put up your hand and we will come to you. Everybody seemed to be covered. Brothers and sisters, this unleavened bread, and the significance is not in the amount, it is just the fact that we can partake of it. This unleavened bread represents that body that was broken, that body that was beaten, that body that was flogged. And in the original language where it talked about him being wounded, that word really means that he was pierced. Where was he pierced? In his hands, his feet, and his side. And the Bible says, because of his wounds, because of his flogging, because of his beating and humiliation, we are not only healed, but we are saved. So as you eat the communion bread today, eat it with a sense of thanksgiving that Jesus paid it all. And it is because of his suffering we can have communion today. Eat ye all of it.
Invite you to return to your Bibles in 1 Corinthians chapter 11. 1 Corinthians chapter 11. We read verses 23 and 24 just a few moments ago, and now we'll read verses 25 and 26. 1 Corinthians chapter 11. Verses 25 and 26. Let's read together. After 4, 3, 4. After the same manner also, he took the cup when he had supped, saying, "This cup is the New Testament in my blood. This do ye, as oft as ye drink it, in remembrance of me. For as often as ye eat this bread and drink this cup, ye do shew the Lord's death till he comes." May God continue to bless us.
Let us pray. We thank you, Heavenly Father, for your spilt blood that washes us and makes us whiter than snow. We thank you for subjecting yourself to the scourgings of man. We thank you so much, seeing our sins, seeing our waywardness, you still decided to go all the way to the cross. And your blood makes it possible that each of us can live victoriously today. We thank you so much for the power that is available through your blood. May we accept that power and that grace in our lives. May as we partake of the emblem today, may we reflect upon your goodness to us and what you have accomplished in our lives. And may we go forth letting others know what a wonderful Savior you are. Bless the wine. Bless it to our bodies. And if perchance there is someone ailing, we know that you can touch. As they reach out in faith and as they take that wine, may there be a transformation in their being. We thank you so much for more than just transforming us physically, that we would be transformed spiritually. We would have the mindset to serve you, come what may. And we thank you in Jesus' precious name. Amen.
Hymn 302, Deeper Yet, Deeper Yet. Let's sing In the Blood.
In the blood from the cross. To be free from dross, still I would enter in.
Deeper yet, let's sing.
Deeper yet, deeper yet, into the crimson flood. Deeper yet, deeper yet, under the precious blood.
Day by day,
day by day.
In the blood, wonder working power. Hymn 294. Let's Let's sing.
Would you be free from the burden of sin?
There is.
There is power in the blood.
Yes, power in the blood.
Would you are even a victory win? There is wonderful power in the blood.
There is power,
power, wonder working power in the blood of the Lamb. There is power, power, wonder working power in the precious blood of the Lamb. Would you be free from your passion and pride? There is power in the blood, power in the blood. Come for a cleansing to Calvary's side. There is wonderful power in the blood.
There is power,
power, wonder working power in the blood of the Lamb. There is power,
power,
wonder working power. Jesus, your King, there is power in the blood.
Yes,
power in the blood.
Would you live
daily His praises to sing? There is wonderful power in the blood. There is power,
power,
wonder-working power in the blood of the Lamb. There is power.
Number 366. There is a 336, sorry. There is a fountain that is filled with blood, drawn from Emmanuel's vein, and sinners plunged beneath that flood lose all their what? Every bit of it. Thank God this morning that there is a fountain that stills, removes all stain from our lives, and that's filled with the blood of Christ. So let's sing this morning as though we have been cleansed from all what? Unrighteousness, and we are leaving here today as a brand new person. There is,
there is
a fountain filled with blood,
fountain filled with blood, drawn from Emmanuel's vein,
and sinners plunge beneath that flood,
and sinners plunge beneath that flood.
Lose all
their guilty stains,
lose all their guilty stains.
I'll save to sin no more.
to say no more till all the ransom church of God are saved to say no more.
All right, we'd ask the choristers to stay right there. We'll sing the rest of the hymn in a second. Take your Bibles, please, to Matthew chapter 26. Matthew chapter 26. And I read from the King James Version. From verse 27, it says, "And he took the cup and gave thanks and gave it to them, saying, drink ye all of it. For this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for many for the remission of sins. But I say unto you, I will not drink henceforth of this fruit of the vine until that day when I drink it new with you in my Father's kingdom." Let us pray, please, at this time. Our Father in heaven, we thank you for the blood of Jesus, that blood that guarantees our washing away of our sins. Now, Lord, we pray that as we celebrate what he did, as we remember what he did, that you will remember us today in mercy and that you would apply the blood of Jesus to our lives. Now, Lord, we pray you would bless these emblems and these, the fruit of this vine, that as those who drink it would be blessed as the others would be, in Jesus' name, amen and amen. All right, so we're finishing this song. Y'all can sit and sing so we can serve you. What stanza are we at? Stanza 4.
Since by faith I saw the stream, the flowing supply, redeeming love has been my team. I shall be till I die. I shall be till I die. I shall be till I die. Redeeming love has been my team. I shall. Lord, I believe thou hast prepared unworthy door.
We have a small problem, which is really not a problem. So here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to ask Brother Cuffy to go sit by his wife. And Brother Johnson, is your wife here? Go sit by her, please. You all got wine? Right. Is your wife here, sir? You don't know where she is? Yeah, go find her. You don't know where she is. Go find her. Go find her. I ain't leaving you out. I'm not leaving you out at all. We will leave you out. No. So I'm going to ask Brother Leonard Johnson. Leonard Pierpartney. Wow, I'm giving you a new Nana Johnson is the division vice president. Well, no, let's do it better than that. Let's get a glass for the elder, please. I would go by my wife. This is not a usual occurrence. And no, we're sharing. Are you sharing with your wife, Joel? Huh? She's saying, oh, she's sharing with her daughter. Okay. This is not a usual thing, but it's a good thing. It simply says that we have a church that is, no, I'm going by my wife. Joel, you go by your wife. I'm going by my wife. Everybody want to show their wife? Yes, that's a good thing. That's a very good thing. So, brethren, let's see. Do we all have? If you don't have, just indicate. And we will tell you to share with your spouse, if your spouse is here. Brothers and sisters, the fruit of the vine is the symbol of the blood of Jesus. That blood which removes every stain of sin. That blood which cleanses us of our sins. Somebody said, I think it is Leviticus. In Leviticus, Moses said that the blood is where the life is. So when you drink communion juice, grape juice, this is not fermented one now. This is not the spoiled one. The one that is decaying. That is what fermentation is. This is the pure fruit of the vine. When you drink it, it is to give you life. Not just life physically, because in drinking it, we are renewed. Amen. But it is to give us life spiritually. So as you drink the grape juice, the fruit of the vine, please drink it knowing that Jesus did this so that you can have life and that you can have it more abundantly. Drink ye all of it. The elders enjoy that. Amen, amen, and amen.
No matter what you have done or where you've been, God's grace, I say God's grace is greater than all our sins. In holy pages, this truth can be found. A promise.
promise to stand on a bound where right never loses and wrong never wins, but grace will always be greater than sin. Grace will always be greater than sin. Calvary has proven it time and again. Broken and bruised from the choices you've made. Sin has a price, and so often you've paid. Oh, but Jesus is waiting. New hope is in him. 'Cause grace will always be greater than sin. Grace will always be greater than sin. Calvary has proven it time and
tell you that this Sabbath is a special Sabbath. Amen? Amen. So we will save the testimonies for another Sabbath because we want to, and we discussed it on the board, and I said to the board, well, I'm not sure if we will do hands of fellowship. It depends on the time, but I'm impressed that we do it today. And so I'm going to ask Anna. Is Anna right? Anna, please come. I'm going to ask young Miss Harding, I'm forgetting your first name. Sierra. Come and have a seat. We're doing Hands of Fellowship differently today. Sierra is Sister Harding's granddaughter. She got baptized just before COVID, and she never got hands of fellowship. Of course, her baptism was at the Rima Church. There was a revival there. And I'm just impressed. And this is her home church, by the way. So we would arrange a transfer of membership for her. And I just want to give both of them hands of fellowship today. So we're going to do the testimonies on another occasion. So we were thinking about emptying the pool. And I said to the head deacon, let's not empty it yet, just in case there is somebody in the church who feels that maybe you want to get baptized today. If you are ready, there is water. And we have gongs. Amen. Maybe you are not, but you would like to say, Lord, if I get a chance on another occasion, not too far from now, I will give my heart to you in full baptism. Is there anybody like that in the congregation today? I'm seeing a hand way down in the back. I'm seeing a child right here. Is there somebody else? Oh, look at hands going up all about the place. Wow. Have mercy, Jesus. Sister Church Clerk, I need all of those hands. Please, put up your hands again so that we can, oh, brothers, amen. You know who they are? All right. Is there one other person? Is there one other person? Maybe there's a young man in this congregation. You're not yet baptized. You know you are not baptized. And you know if you don't follow the Lord and give your heart to him and get baptized, you will be lost. Is there a young man like that in the congregation today? Put up your hand. Put it up. Is there another person? Maybe a young lady, a more mature woman, somebody else. God bless you. And so today we want to present these two young ladies with special gifts. Amen. I visited the Hardings on the 12th of March. And I prayed with them. I spent a long time with them. And somebody came to my office and said to me, Pastor, here's a special book. The very next day, here's a special book. And when I looked at the book, I said, why are you bringing it to me? And she says, well, I'm impressed to bring it for you. She said, Pastor, take it. And whenever you could, pay me for it. And then I remembered the Hardings. I had made a visit the day before, and this very book, specific to the Hardings, came to my office. And so, couldn't lose this opportunity. I spoke to the board about it, and we agreed that we would give the Hardings a special gift. So I'm going to ask the church clerk to come and present to Sierra. Sierra, right? Special gift. Oh, a clerk and assistant clerk. And to Anna, a special gift as well. So now we will want to welcome them officially to our church. And those of you whose hands went up, one of these days soon, you will get your special time at the hands of fellowship. So we will sing the song. Blessed be the tide that binds our hearts in Christian love. I'm going to ask the elders to start first. Board members, you come next. And then other members. This is our testimony service for today. We just want to welcome these two souls
to the church, to our church, to the Horquetta church. Remember, Sierra got baptized in Arima, but her mother and her grandmother, where is Sister Harding? Oh, there she is. They are members of this church. And so this is her church. This is where she came to church before, by the way, all along. All right? So, blessed be the tie that binds our hearts, in Christian love. So we'll do the elders, deacons, deaconesses.
Hymn 350, blessed be the tide that binds.
We'd ask the other elders to come as well.
Christian, join to sing. Hallelujah. Amen. Loud praise to Christ our King. Hallelujah. Amen. So let's come and join together as we sing. Let's go together.
Come, Christian, join to sing.
Oh,
Before we sing the next song, is there anybody else who would like to come? If you're coming, come now, so that we can seal it off like the icing on the cake, in Jesus' name. Anybody else? Nobody else.
5, 2, 6. God.
Number one, praise to the Lord, the Almighty, the King of creation. Oh, my soul, praise him, for he is my what? My health and salvation. All you here, now to his temple draw near, join in glad adoration.
Before we sing, you know, it's so interesting. Some of the young people who got baptized and who got hands of fellowship 2 Sabbaths ago, they made their way up, including one Miss Robertson, who is not yet baptized, and she made her way up. Amen. Amen.
Okay, we'll sing one stanza of praise to the Lord, and then we'll turn to 5, 2, 6. Because he lives, we can face tomorrow. So we will use that as our closing hymn, and we'll want to pick up the offering for the poor and the needy. So we ask the deacons if they can take their places. We'll pick up the offering for the poor and the needy at this time. So let's all stand as we sing our closing hymn.
God sent his son.
They call him Jesus.
He came to love.
Heal and forgive.
Because he lives, all fair. the love of angels, because he lives,
because he
lives, I can face tomorrow,
because he
lives, all fear is gone, because I know
he
holds the future.
Let's bow our heads as we pray. Father in heaven, we thank you for the hope we have in Jesus, which hope was illustrated in the emblems we partook of. We thank you that because he lives, we can face tomorrow. And we can look forward to the second coming too. We thank you for Jesus. Thanks for leading us through this wonderful experience where our hope was buoyed up. In Jesus' holy name, amen. And let's pray on the offering. Father in heaven, we pray your blessings on the offerings we have collected for the needy. In Jesus' holy name.
As we depart 626, in a little while, we're going home.
And as we sing the hymn, I told you today is a special communion service. We couldn't do it because of COVID, but now COVID is gone, practically, for the most part. So I want you to find somebody and give a hug, give a kiss. Give a good strong handshake and encourage that person to serve the Lord. That's all you have to do. A hug, a handshake, a kiss, and encourage that person to serve the Lord. God bless you. Happy Sabbath, everyone.
Let us sing.
Let us sing a song that will cheer us by the way. In a little while we're going home, and the night will end in the everlasting day. In a little while we're going home.
In a little while.
In a little while. In a little while. We shall cross the billows home. We shall meet at last where the stormy winds are past. In a little while we're going home.
We will do
the work that our hands may find to do. In a little while we're going home. And the grace of God in our daily strength renew. In a little while we're going home.
In a little while.
In a little while. In a little while. Across the billows home, we shall meet at last when the stormy winds are past. In a little while we're going home. We will smooth the path for some weary wayward feet. In a little while we're going home. And may loving hearts spread around at its best feet. In a little while we're going home.
In a little while.
In a little while. In a little while. We shall cross the billows home. We shall meet at last when the stormy winds are past. In a little while we're going home. There's a rest beyond. There's relief from every care. In a little while we're going home. And no tear shall fall in that
city bright and fair. In a little while we're going home. In a little while, in a little while, we shall cross the billows foam. We shall meet at last when the stormy winds are past. In a little while we're going home.
What a mighty God
we
Just one announcement before we continue. Persons driving the cars to the center of the car park, please attend to your vehicle so others can leave, please. Persons driving the cars in the center of the car park, please attend to your vehicle so others can leave.
Okay,
oh, magnify the Lord.
Magnify,
oh, magnify the Lord, for He is worthy to be praised. Hosanna, blessed be the rock, blessed be the rock of my salvation. Hosanna, blessed be the rock, blessed be the rock of my table. I know He is able. I know my Lord is able to guide me through. He's able, He's able. I know
He is able.
I know my Lord is able to guide me through.
For He has,
for He has healed the brokenhearted and set the captives free. He made the lame to walk again and caused the blind to see. I know He's able, He's able, I know.
He is able.
I know my Lord is able to guide me through.
Well, if I should die on a pilgrim journey, heaven is my home.
If I should die on a pilgrim journey, heaven is my home. Heaven, heaven, heaven is my home. Heaven is my home. If I should die on a pilgrim journey, heaven is my home. Heaven, heaven, heaven is my home. Heaven, heaven, heaven is my home.
Alleluia.
Anyhow, never, never let life troubles get you down. When life troubles come your way, hold your head. Friend, tell them that you are saved, sanctified.
baptized, Jesus is mine. I found a new life.
Sing it again.
I found a new life. I found a new life. If anybody asks you, what's the matter with you, my friend? Tell them that you are saved.